Well, typically in the morning, I usually wake up and go downstairs and get my shower going, start getting ready to leave. But I don't get a lot of activities done, mainly due to the fact that it's dark when I leave for work almost every day of the year.
So normally in the morning I start out by watering and letting out all the animals, making sure they have food. Now I'm letting the little ducks out. Now we gotta let out the big ducks and all the kitties. Good morning, Deuce. Get you some food. And then I've been leaving this open to start getting them incorporated with the big ducks here soon. Now we feed the little ones. Come on, Pretzel. I got food for you. And then check chicken feed. I already got one loose, the white ones and my other flighty ones, amberlings. They like to sneak out right away during the day. Next, what I do is I just make sure there wasn't any straggler for eggs. And this is kind of poopy, so I'll refill it with some new straw. And hopefully the eggs won't be poopy later. And then lastly, what I've been doing is I've been letting the little kittens run around in the barn after they had breakfast. So I'll shut the door and let them loose. This whole area of the barn is going to be changing pretty soon. What we're going to do is we're going to build this all up and make a second coop because I ordered more chickens. They're going to be meat chickens this time though. So we do have about a dozen meat birds coming. Keep them over here, grow them, and then we're gonna start breeding them and hatching our own. And then usually Tula comes in here with me. Now it's time for work. The kids and I ran out here to pick some carrots for some venison stew I'm making for dinner tonight.
Good to be home. So I got a couple things I want to work on tonight, get done, and Sarah's gonna come out in a little bit and help me. She's just finishing up a few things inside, but what we got going on here is in the greenhouse last week at some point we had a storm come through with some straight line winds, and if you watch the Chaos Garden video, you saw that through the middle of the Chaos Garden, all of the corn got flattened, about a 5 foot wide section. Pretty strange how that can happen, just that one spot got damaged. But some of the other damage that we ended up having was with the greenhouse, and it split open one of the sides on the one greenhouse. And what my actual plan was is for next year, I was gonna put an additional wrap over the top of the whole thing. That way, it just was kind of double layered or a little bit thicker or whatever. But so I didn't plan on doing this, but right now I got to come up with a temporary solution. I think we got enough plastic left to at least go over the top and wrap this one. I got a little bit of trimming to do, but that's no big deal. So looks pretty good. Go take a look at the inside.
We're just raking up the chicken coop, the outdoor portion of it, because they get a lot of fresh veggies and kitchen scraps. So we're just cleaning all that up and scraping up some of the poop. Never successfully grown rosemary, but I did it on accident, so that's awesome. I'm just out doing a little harvesting in the chaos garden, which is looking amazing. I'm super excited about my sunflowers. I did not think that they were gonna get ahead this year.
Yeah, you're a mess. You were in the pond. Let me see your smile. You know, the one thing about building a homestead with full-time jobs is that, you know, Sarah and I over the past 5 years have managed to streamline a lot of what we do to make things easier for us. She kind of has things that she does, and I kind of have things that I do.
Every year it gets a little bit easier because you learn a little bit more.
Yeah, absolutely. But we thank you for joining us in our day and checking out what we do here.
If you enjoyed this content and would like to see us grow, please like, share, and subscribe. And thank you for watching.